I received a lot of emails lately on my YouTube and Instagram from some of you asking me that a lot of my videos are a little bit too advanced. So basically you guys asked me to do a little bit more simple stuff. Therefore, I decided to do DaVinci Resolve 17 bootcamp. So basically what we're going to do in that bootcamp, we're going to take a huge step back and start learning DaVinci Resolve from the very basics, from the very beginning. So if you're just learning DaVinci Resolve or you're switching from other program, this series is going to be for you. It's going to be a special playlist designed to watch all the way from the beginning to an end. So we're going to do a nice bootcamp series for Resolve. Now, for those of you who are watching me for the first time, probably thinking, who the hell is this guy? My name is Aram K. I'm a professional film colorist with over 10 years of experience in the industry. I do teach DaVinci Resolve professionally, and I work in the film industry also as cinematographer. In this bootcamp series, we're going to be taking a look back at DaVinci Resolve from very basics, how to load things, what certain parameters are. I'm going to show you a few tricks and basically stuff like that. Now, since it's a very first introduction video, I want to talk about a little bit of basic requirements for DaVinci Resolve. I also get this question a lot. So what do you really need in order to start working with DaVinci Resolve? Well, that depends on what is your final goal. Let's talk about really the basics as far as the gear goes. First of all, the processor. The processor for DaVinci Resolve for your computer, you much better off having a gaming processor, meaning faster frequency rather than amount of cores. DaVinci Resolve, even though they say they do, they don't really utilize the large amount of cores. So for example, if you have 64 core at something like 1.5 gigahertz, it may not be as good as, for example, having 12 cores at 4 gigahertz. So be sure if you assemble your computer or you want to kind of learn a little bit what's better for Resolve, faster processor is much better versus number of cores. Now, the second one comes graphics card. Graphics card on DaVinci Resolve extremely important if you're planning on doing video editing larger than 4K, for example. You can get away right now with 8 gigabytes of video RAM to edit and do basic color grading for 4K video. However, if you want to do more complex effects like noise reduction or drop some effects that come with DaVinci Resolve, 8 gigabytes is not enough, and you're going to be constantly getting error that Resolve is out of memory or a similar thing like that. Now, that being said, you probably have another question. One graphics cards or two? My answer is, in my opinion, again, if you're not running a studio or anything like that, you're better off having one powerful GPU versus two mediocre ones. So if you're assembling your computer and you're thinking just put like a bunch of lower grade graphics card, don't do that. Better buy one good one. DaVinci Resolve does not split or add memory. Meaning, let's say you have two mediocre cards at 8 gigabytes each, right? If you put two of them together, you will not get 16 gigabytes. It doesn't work like that. You still be working with the 8 gigabyte video RAM. So keep that in mind. Another one is the hard drive. The hard drive is very important, especially right now, again, that we have 4K files, 6K, 8K, 12K. It's very important that your drive is fast enough. The old school 7200 RPM drives are no longer good enough to do color grading. So again, if you're serious about using Resolve for professional work or you really want to have real-time playback, I highly recommend getting either SSD, it can be external SSD, or NVMe drive. You get much better performance with them, and it's very important when you have real-time playback. I actually have done video about it. If you want, look up on my channel. I'm basically explaining how to get real-time playback in DaVinci Resolve. So those are the main, basically, factors. Now, as far as the monitor goes, any modern monitor, IPS or equivalent panel, is good enough. Most modern monitors cover Rec. 709, which is still a standard when it comes to color grading. And basically, as long as you calibrate your monitor using calibration tool, again, I've done video on that, look it up, you are good to go. You don't need to have expensive monitor, for example, like I have here, the Asus, which is almost, $4,000 or $5,000. Very expensive monitor. However, in the future, you probably want to get one, because once you're going to get more advanced, you're going to be grading in a larger space than Rec 709. That being said, if you're just learning, again, any monitor will do. As long as your computer is fast enough, basically, you're going to be good to go. So those are pretty much like a minimum requirements. As far as the RAM, you probably want to have at least 16 gigabytes of RAM. For 4K, you want to have at least 32, and anything above 4K video, I would highly recommend having 64 gigabytes of RAM. That way you're not going to have any kind of RAM related issues, especially again when you're going to be dropping additional effects on your footage, because those effects are usually pretty RAM hungry. So anyways, this is the first introduction video. From now on, we're going to start actually doing things in Resolve. I just wanted to take time and quickly kind of talk about a little basic requirements right now, 2021, DaVinci Resolve 17, so basically where we're at when it comes to computer power. Anyways, be sure to check out videos, subscribe to this playlist, and I'm going to see you guys next time. Take care.